So we feel that the batting order is more or less balanced now, and now these 18 games would be to give the perfect combination that we want to take into the World Cup. All games together, barring injuries or niggles. We want one combination to play through and through, and apart from bowlers resting here and there in one-day cricket, we only changed the number 4 slot because we wanted someone to cement it. But we believe that Raidu is the right person to capitalize, and because he's experienced and he's won many games for his state in IPL cricket as well, and you know, he has a great one-day record already for India. So I think the batting order is sorted as far as we are concerned now. See, I think what happens is you look at things the way you want to. A side like England, you see anyone stepping out at number 3 according to the situation of the game. I think what happens here is that more often than not, people want to create controversies out of nothing. If you're looking forward as a team, if I have to bat number 5 and openers bat till 30th over, we would send someone who can do a better job than me. You know, there's no rocket science to it. Even in T20 cricket, you do that all the time. You're flexible in what you want to do as a batting order. So, yeah, those positions invariably, you would want a consistent batting lineup. But if there is a situation where at 40 overs, you're only 2 down, then, you know, someone who can capitalize those next 4 or 5 overs better can step in. So, as a team, we understand that. And the batting order is always ready, especially after 4. You know, the guys below 4 are always flexible in terms of the situation can be anything. So it's all about what the team wants to do in that particular situation, and obviously you want the best thing for the team, and being flexible is very, very important. As I said, number 4 was something that we were looking for a long time, and with Raidu coming in and playing well in the Asia Cup, and you know, giving him enough game time from now till the World Cup, I think that particular slot will be sorted for us. And if you see our one-day performances, there's not much to, you know, ponder on apart from that one slot I spoke about. So the bowlers are bowling well, the batsmen have batted well. The lower order hasn't got much batting because, you know, Shikhar, Rohit and myself have made a lot of runs. But having those experienced guys in the middle order will definitely help us, and we feel quite settled as a batting order now. See, we don't want to leave any bases uncovered. So we thought bringing a left arm into the mix will give us enough variety in terms of whoever we play against, the kind of opposition we play against. If you see, we have two wrist spinners. So in a scenario where a finger spinner might play with a wrist spinner, then you see whether there are enough right-handers for a leggy to play, or there are enough left-handers for a Chinaman to play. So as a team, you want as many options as possible so that you field your best bowling attack against that batting lineup. And bringing in a left-arm like Khalil, who has ability to swing the ball both ways, gets good bounce as well and bowls at decent pace, I think is always an added luxury to have in a team. And that definitely makes the job easier for people like Bhuvi and Bumrah, who, you know, will obviously feed off another variety in the bowling attack as well. So I think it's a great thing to have a left-arm seamer after so long, after, you know, Zach and Ashish Nehra. After that, we haven't really had a left-arm seamer. So it's good to see someone who's come up the ranks and provides variety to the bowling lineup.